हेलो व्यूअर्स, माय नेम अशोक सेन गुप्ता फ्रॉम स्कूल ऑफ मैनेजमेंट साइंसेज लखनऊ। टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द कॉम्पोजिट कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी वर डिस्कस्ड दैट हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द कॉस्ट ऑफ डिबेंचर, कॉस्ट ऑफ प्रेफरेंस शेयर, कॉस्ट ऑफ इक्विटी। बट इन प्रैक्टिस कंपनी हैविंग अ proper capital structure in which there is a mixture of various sources of fund, and as a financial manager we must understand that we company must not depend on one source of fund and minimize the overall cost of capital. So by how it will minimize, how we can calculate the cost of capital of every source of fund, it is by using composite cost of capital method. It is a kind of weightage method in which we proportionate the weight of individual source of finance. Weightage average cost of capital is the average cost of various source of finance. It is the average cost of various source of finance. We have a source of finance like debt, we have source of finance like equity, we have source of finance like preference shares, we have source of finance like retained earning. All are the sources of finance. Now if any company try to maintain its proper capital structure by using the combination of equity and debt, preference, equity, debt, or for all four, or only debt and equity. So it is basically depends how much it impact its overall cost of capital. Ultimately, if the cost of capital increases, it will give negative impact on the earnings, profits. Similarly, companies or you can say finance manager, top managers also have to decide how they satisfy the both equity shareholders and the debenture shareholders, because equity shareholders always find difficulties when company impose more and more debt at certain level of time, after certain level of time. So there is always a chance, an equity shareholder always predict that their earnings, their dividend must be increased. Similarly, we have to pay a fixed interest to debenture holders. By doing so, we have a huge cost, we have impact of cost. So how we can maintain the cost? What are the various proportions if we take of equity and cost debentures, it minimize the cost. So in this method we can able to find out the cost of composite weightage, also known as cost of composite capital or composite cost of capital. Weightage average method is also known as composite cost of capital. We can compute the cost, this composite cost of capital, by putting weight of specific cost, by putting weight on specific cost of capital in proportion to the various sources, in proportion to the various sources. Here we put the weightage. We apply the weightage of the sources and multiply the sources with the weightage and get the overall cost of the capital. Since cost of equity we can calculate, cost of preference we can calculate, we also understand how to calculate the debentures cost. But if all three are come together and any company issues or borrow fund from all these sources. In this case, we have to manage the cost of capital by weighting average method. The formula, now talk about the formula. It is as simple as we understand in or we study in statistics that any average is the total number of article or total value of the article divided by number of the articles. So, here cost KW is the cost of weighted average or composite cost equals to sigma, sigma is the sign of sum, sigma XW is a multiplication, XW, X is a one variable, W is a another weightage of the variable, we multiply X and Y and then add all of them, add all of them. Like if if X it is X and it is Y, then or W here, these are the variables and these are the sources A, B, C, they are C sources X, Y, W, X, W, X, W, X, W. So, X, W equals to X 1, W 1, X 2, W 2, X 3, W 3 and here we add all these sigma X W, sigma X W divided by sigma your total number of weightage divided by total number of weightage, this is sigma W. So, we can able to find out by this method formula how to calculate the weightage average cost of capital or composite cost of capital. To understand more, we will do some example, numerical example. So, it help us to understand how to calculate the proportion of weightage in the weighted cost of composite. Okay. So, here I have a question. Question is, a firm has following capital structure and after tax cost for different sources of fund. Calculate cost of capital is a simple question. So, these are the data here given that and in data it is clearly mentioned that source of funds are debt, preference share, equity shares, retained earnings, debt, preference shares, equity shares and retained earnings. Company finance themselves from debt which is equals to 15 lakh, company borrow 15 lakh from debentures, this is 15 lakh. Company also borrowed 12 lakhs from equity share. Company also borrowed 12 lakh from equity share. Eighteen lakh from equity share and 12 lakh from preference shares, and 15 lakh from retained earning, and 15 lakh from retained earning. So total company borrow from the various sources, four type of sources, 1, 2, 3 and 4, four types of sources, the total borrowing of the company is 60 lakhs, total borrowing of the company is 60 lakhs. So, now out of 60 lakhs, proportion of debt is 25%. Proportion of debt is 25%. How we can calculate this one? Proportion of debt is 25%, simple 15 lakh divided by 60 lakh total into 100, subtract this, 15 lakh divided by 60 lakh, 4 divided by 25. So total borrowings, in total borrowing 25% is related to the debt. Similarly, 20% related to the preference shares, like 12 divided by 60 into 100, 20%, 12 divided by 60, we just do the common, 0 ko common le liya, into 100, a 0 se a 0 kata, 2 into 10 20, 18 divided by 60, 200, 30% होना चाहिए, yes, 30%, 18 divided 60 into 100, and remaining retained earning is 15%. So it is also equal to 25%. So debt is 25%, preference share 20, equity 30%, and retained earning 20% as a source of finance. Cost after tax, it is given in the question. Cost after tax. So we are adjusting the cost in tax in debentures. So after tax cost is 5%. Individual cost. As after tax individual cost is 5%. This is 10%, 12%, and 11%. It is given in the question. Now, proportionate weightage, yani W, proportionate weightage, that means W is already given 25%, 20%, 30%, 25%. X is percentage of cost. X is percentage of cost. So, X is this one. We need to calculate weightage cost percentage of proportion, weightage cost percentage of proportion, this into cost. So, 21 equals to 25%, 5% of 25, 5% of 25, 25 fours, yeah, and so 1.25. So, we multiply this and this and find out the proportion percentage, proportionate percent. Cost hamari debt ki 5% hai, debenture 25% hai, to hamara weightage kitna hoga debenture ka cost mein, to humne nikal liya 1.25%, the simple method. In this case, 10 divided by 20, sorry, in this case 20 ka 10%, 0 se 0 gaya, 2, preference earning ka mein nikla 2, XW equals to 2. equals to 30 ka 12% 3.6 ho gaya, yeah, and retained earning ka 11%, retained earning ka 25 ka 11% hum nikalna hai, 25 के 11% निकल गया 2.75. When we add all these three, when we add all, we get the answer 9.60. we get the answer 9.60. अदरवाइज हमें क्या करना पड़ता, हमें पहले इन दोनों को मल्टीप्लाई करते फिर डिवाइड करते, देखते हैं क्या होता है. लेट्स सी, इन दोनों को मल्टीप्लाई करते हैं 50 200 360 और 25 11, मुझे कितना होता अभी 25 11 25, टोटल 5 11 18 6 8, और टोटल वेटेज कितना है हमारे पास 100. तो जो फॉर्मूला है उसके हिसाब से हम ये निकालेंगे कि कैसे हम प्रोपोर्शनेट करके निकाल सकते हैं. अगर कॉस्ट दे रखी हो तो, अगर कॉस्ट दे रखी हो तो, कभी का क्वेश्चंस में वैल्यूज़ भी दे रखी होती हैं, कभी का क्वेश्चंस में वैल्यूज़ भी दे रखी होती हैं. जैसे कि इस क्वेश्चन में है, इन द फर्म है, इट इज़ अ फर्म हैज 18,000 इक्विटी शेयर रुपीज 100 each outstanding and current market price is 300 per share. Calculate the market value and book value of the debt and preference shares. इस क्वेश्चन में, प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन में ऐड करके हमें इस नए क्वेश्चन को बनाया गया है. तो इस क्वेश्चन में आप देखिए, प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन में डेप्ट था 15 लाख, प्रिफ्रेंस शेयर कैपिटल था 12 लाख. अब इक्विटी, पिछले में इक्विटी में क्या किया गया कि इक्विटी में 18,000 इक्विटी शेयर इशू किए गए और 300 रुपये का था, 300 रुपीज़ इक्विटी शेयर. सो दिस इज 18,000 × 300, टोटल आया 54 का, ये हो गया वेटेज कैपिटल. इनका हमने क्या कर दिया, हमने वी एडेड ऑल दिस थिंग, वी एड दिस प्लस दिस प्लस दिस, वी एड प्रोपोर्शन, वेट प्रोपोर्शन. सो दिस इज 15 lakh is near about 18%, 12 lakh is near about 14%, and remaining is the proportion of equity share. Remaining is the proportion of equity share, therefore, it is 6.667 lakh percentage. So, here is 100%, total is 100%. In previous question, it is clearly defined that cost 5, 10, 12. So, we also include this cost in this question, 5, 10 and 12. So, 5% of 18.52 is 9.3. 18.52 multiplied by 5%. 14.18 का 10%, ये तो बहुत इजी है. 14.81 का 10% निकालना, इसको हटाइए यहाँ से, 10 कर दिया, डिवाइड कर दिया, पॉइंट इधर इसका क्या आ गया, तो 1.18. 67.67 का 12%, 67.67 का 12%. It is approximately 8. It is approximately 8. So, when we add all these 5, 3 elements, debentures, preference share capital and equity share, our total cost or composite cost incurred during the finance of 3 is 10.41%. So, with the help of this formula, I am trying to show you how we calculate the overall or weightage cost of capital, I just make your summary, the lecture recap. So, because if there is an issue, then you can understand more. So, in this topic, we read about the weightage cost of capital. It is the average cost of capital, various source of finance. It is also known as cost of composite capital. We can compute the cost of capital by putting weightage of specific cost of capital in proportion to the various sources or value of sources in proportion to the value of sources. Formula jo humne dekha, we find the formula that x w divided by or sigma w, k w is a cost of capital or composite cost of capital, sigma x w divided by sigma w. Sigma is a specific cost, x is specific cost and w is weightage proportion, total aapka jo finance hua hai uska kitna weightage ek source ko mila hai. Agar aapke 3 source of finance hain, agar aapke x y aur z aur ye ho gaya del alpha, to iska jo weightage proportion hoga wo hoga, वेटेज प्रोपोर्शन जो होगा वो सिंपल होगा x डिवाइडेड बाय अल्फा इनटू 100, कितना वेटेज हुआ, y डिवाइडेड बाय अल्फा इनटू 100 और z डिवाइडेड बाय अल्फा इनटू 100. टोटल प्रोपोर्शन का, टोटल आपका जो सोर्स ऑफ फाइनेंस है उसका कितना परसेंट, कितना प्रोपोर्शन हमें अलग अलग लिखना पड़ेगा, निकालना पड़ेगा और फिर हम उसमें मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे किस चीज़ का, कॉस्ट का. लाइक इन दिस क्वेश्चन हमने किया था, मैं फिर समझा देता हूँ. कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल 60 लाख, टोटल 60 लाख हमारे पास है. कंपनी ने डेप्ट लिया 15 लाख का, कंपनी ने प्रेफरेंस शेयर लिया 12 लाख का, इक्विटी 18 लाख एंड रिटेन अर्निंग 15 लाख. दीज आर द 4 सोर्सेज ऑफ फाइनेंस फ्रॉम विच कंपनी अर्न और कंपनी गेट 60,000. नाउ अकॉर्डिंग टू द फॉर्मूला वी नीड टू कन्वर्ट इन प्रोपोर्शनेट. सो प्रोपोर्शनेट ऑफ डेप्ट इज 25%. वी कैलकुलेट बाई 15,000 डिवाइडेड बाई 15 लाख डिवाइडेड बाई 60 लाख, we get 25,000. Preference share 12 lakhs divided by 60,000, equity 18 lakh divided by 60,000 and retain 15 lakhs divided by 60,000. As we know the cost of individual source, we put cost there 5, 10, 12 and 11. While computing the cost of, equity share, composite share, composite cost of capital, we multiply the proportionate weight, percentage weightage into percentage of x, यानी कि आपको proportion निकाल, जो proportion है w है उसका percentage निकालना है cost के साथ, उसका multiply cost के साथ करना है. So, 25% divided by multiply by 5%. तो 25 का 5% होता है 1.25. Similarly, preference share 20 का 10% 2, 30 का 12% 3.6 and 25 का 11% 2.75. सो 2.75 हमने निकाल लिया और हमने इसका टोटल कर लिया। टोटल करने के बाद हमें पता लगा कि हमारे पास टोटल परसेंटेज ऑफ कॉस्ट ऑफ कंपोजिट था, टोटल परसेंटेज ऑफ कॉस्ट ऑफ कंपोजिट था वो 9.60 था। हमने फिर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन देखा, उसमें हमने नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन में हमने देखा कि हमने 18,000 इक्विटी शेयर्स जो 100 रुपये के थे, जहाँ 18 लाख कर रहे थे वहाँ पे हम, अब वो मार्केट प्राइस के हिसाब से 300 के हो गए, 100 से या बढ़ के 300 के हो गए। तो सेम क्वेश्चन में हम लोगों ने क्या किया, वी चेंज दी इक्विटी शेयर बाई 100 to 300। द न्यू इक्वेशन इज इक्विटी शेयर इज 18,000 डिवाइडेड इंटू 300 एंड वी गेट द 54 लैक्स। सो अगेन वी फाइंड आउट द प्रपोर्शन ऑफ इक्विटी इन 81,000, दैट इज 67, 12 डिवाइडेड बाई 81, 14, 15 डिवाइडेड बाई 18, दिस इज प्रपोर्शनल। वी फाइंड आउट द 5%, 10%, 12% ऑफ ईच ऑफ दैम एंड डू द टोटल। सो दिस इज द कॉम्पोजिट कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल। सो माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, होप यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस टॉपिक क्लियरली, हाउ वी कैलकुलेट द कॉस्ट ऑफ इक्विटी, प्रिफरेंस शेयर्स, डिवेंचर्स एंड फाइनली द कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल और वेटेज कैपिटल। दीज आर द बुक्स विच यू कैन रिफर फॉर योर फर्दर इंफॉर्मेशन। थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो।